Hello there guys and welcome back to the channel. So today's video is going to be all about Wasp. So I have been meaning to make this video for quite a while, but recently I came upon some very interesting interactions and I happened to pull a 6-star Wasp, so that pretty much put me over the edge and I figured there is no time like today, so I am making the video about Wasp finally. So as we all know, Wasp is essentially Ghost's BFF. They both work extremely well together, and however, Wasp often gets left kind of in Ghost's shadow, and I think undeservedly. Unfortunately, most of the Wasps that I have seen ranked are pretty much either for Alliance Ward defense or just for the Wasp prestige. However, Wasp has so much to offer, and today we are gonna try our best to show exactly what Wasp can do and where she can kind of fill in the blanks where Ghost might struggle, and exactly why Wasp is a great champion that is worthy of your time and resources and practice. So first we're going to be doing a couple of Realm of Legends fights just to kind of measure her damage output, which FYI is quite impressive. Also, Wasp is pretty much the highest base attack champion in game. Many people say her downfall is the low health pool and low block proficiency. However, Wasp doesn't really block. That's the beauty about her. She does not need to rely on parry. She does not need to block opponents' hits often at all. And because of that, I don't think that is kind of a deal breaker where it could be if her playstyle were any different. However, this time Kabam actually made a good job making sure that her downside kind of doesn't come really into play if you're playing the character correctly. Therefore, it doesn't really stop her from being an amazing character. So, the single most amazing thing Wasp can do is she can place a passive, that's right, passive stun on opponent if you chain heavy attack to your regular hit combo. That combo can be as small as one hit, so long as you manage to find an opening, get a hit against an opponent, then start charging your heavy attack, opponent's gonna be stunned and your heavy attack is always gonna land safely. That lets her spam heavy attacks like nobody else in game. And that is becoming more and more useful, especially in Act 6, where a lot of nodes kind of like require you to do so. And since the stun is passive, you will be able to do it against stun immune opponents, against stuff like Mordog, King Groot, basically everybody where you typically couldn't do that easily. So as you can see here, Wasp is going to town, and also you can notice that she's pretty much critting all the time. That is because every time Wasp shrinks down to her micro size, her next two hits are guaranteed to be critical. So pretty much both hits of the heavy attack or whenever we shrink down. Also, a nice trick what we can do is we can chain our special attacks to our heavy attack, and therefore making sure the beginning of our special attack also crits. Wasp shrinks down during her special attack, so majority of that special attack will crit. So anyways, here with class disadvantage, but keep in mind, class disadvantage, we took down Winter Soldier in 95 hits. That is some really, really solid damage output. So in these videos, I'm also utilizing Nick Fury synergy with Quake or Ant-Man. In this case, it's Nick Fury and Ant-Man. And what the synergy states is, basically, whenever opponent would hit us and we're not blocking, we have 100% chance to evade. And yeah, that's what it does. So it's guaranteed evade for us. However, there is a beautiful side on it, because whenever Wasp evades, she shrinks down and she places passive, she places shock on opponent. And that works with the synergy. And that's absolutely amazing. I'm going to be showing some more examples where it can be really useful later on. But for now, it just let's keep that in mind. So we have a 100% guaranteed chance to evade in case if we do mess up. Sometimes I kind of let her hit me on purpose just to place shock on it, because the more debuffs opponent has, the higher our critical damage on our critical hits. But as you can see here, Wasp has a really also long range heavy attack that pretty much lets her chain it back to back even while opponent is down. Therefore, combined with her passive stun and with her long range heavy attack, we can use our heavy attacks multiple times in a row while opponent's pinned against the wall, and that is where there will be majority of the fight. And the good thing is, this bypasses all the immunities, all the stun immunities, and we can keep on doing it indefinitely pretty much. Therefore, this is another example where Wasp does not rely on parries or kind of finding openings, because you will basically keep heavying opponents till they reach a bar of power, bait out a special attack and go back to your heavy method. So that is super easy way to play Wasp. Also, if you do not enjoy throwing as many heavy attacks, just a simple fact that you can chain a heavy attack at end of your 4-hit combo basically grants opponents more power, and every time you do a full combo with your heavy attack, almost gives opponent one bar of power. Therefore, again, you do not have to parry pretty much in any fight aside from like initial one or two combos, and then for entire fight you can make sure opponent has enough power gained from you striking them, basically for the fight to go that you finish your combo, bait out their special attack, you finish your combo, bait out their special attack, you finish your combo, chain in special attack, and so on and so on. So Wasp has a really kind of unique playstyle that Blade can do really well as well, just because of how quickly he gains power, where he can shoot a special attack pretty much after every single one of his combos. Therefore, you need to rely on intercept or parry a lot less than any other champions. So here we go, 91 hits, even though I made a few slight mistakes or didn't utilize my damage to the most, but still 90 hits, Captain Marvel down 500k damage. That's just insane. Right, so this next fight is in Act 6, Chapter 2, Quest 3 against Icarus Node. So as you can see, we are gaining the Furies, but we're going to be taking a look first of all of how well Wasp can handle the Global Node itself, because she does it absolutely great just because of the amount of heavy attacks she spams. So she pretty much never has to worry about having those Furies on her expiring and causing her degen. And then we're going to be taking a look at also Yellow Jacket synergy with Wasp, which basically lets her place a concussion on opponent that reduces their ability accuracy by 100% once you intercept. Now, with Wasp, it's super safe to intercept when we have the Nick Fury synergy, so there's literally no risk involved. So now we just need to try and kind of nail an intercept, which we did now. Opponents under concussion means there's no glancing, so we can deal our full amount of damage like we did here, huge level 2, and then all the power sting damage on top of it, and Ant-Man is nearly down. So Wasp is proving herself to be more and more useful throughout entire Act 6, to be fair, just because how well she interacts with many of kind of more annoying nodes. So yeah, Wasp is definitely a good champion for clearing a lot of Act 6 content. And now we're going to be taking a look at next fight. And next fight is going to be... what it is? Oh, that is in 6.4. And that is against that quite annoying shielded node. I know many people are cursing that node. But again, Wasp is really good at getting openings without having a need to parry, without kind of taking any block damage. Therefore, Wasp deals extremely well with all of this chapter as well. Just of... yeah, how you can intercept, still fail and succeed at the same time just because of Nick Fury's synergy, just because you can pin opponents against the wall with your heavy attacks, and in general, you're going to have a pretty easy time in 6.4 when dealing with this annoying node. I think I will make a small slip up towards the end there, just because I'm not going to quite kill him with this. But yeah, I thought I pushed him to, yeah, so there was a mistake, but he got power stung and the fight's still over. However, Wasp did her part great. We do not need to parry, we do not need to block in order to find openings. That's why nodes like that are going to be perfect. Also, in 6-2-1, first of all, that lifecycle node can be quite annoying as well, just because you need to knock opponents down while, and then try and KO them while that basically shield is disabled. And second, the most annoying path in 6-2-1 was that aspect of Warpath. However, here we're going to explore one of the most interesting bits of how Nick Fury synergy interacts with Wasp. So basically, whenever we would trigger Nick Fury synergy with Wasp, Wasp's shrink down and shock ability activates. What does that mean? That means that it technically counts as a landed hit on opponent, and in case when opponent's dashing at you, it counts as an intercept. So let's see it right here. So aspect of war unstoppable activated, we let him try and strike us and we immediately disable the unstoppable. So Wasp is absolutely fantastic with dealing aspect of war pretty much everywhere, so long as you have Nick Fury's energy. And that is just a really kind of awesome piece of utility I didn't think of at first, but it works out so great just to absolutely demolish that aspect of war node. And yeah, I definitely think that brings a lot of value to her, and I think more people should take a look at it. So here are we going to be taking a look at basically the same interaction, and while the fight's happening in the background, I just wanted to mention that Wasp is also perfect for this life cycle node as well, just because of how frequently and how easily she can knock opponents down by heavy attacks, therefore extending the shield duration. Therefore she does not have much of a problem disabling the shield, and her level 2 has power sting on it. That means like if you happen to knock opponent down and disable the shield and they launch their special attack, they're gonna die immediately after. However, so let's try and do this thing again. So here we are going for level 1. So now he's launching his special attack, he's unstoppable. He attacks us, we immediately disable it, and we can just go for intercept and finish the fight off there. Right here, we disabled lifecycle node, did another heavy attack, and the fight is over. And the next fight in the video is going to be in 625 with Do Not Be Gentle global node, which basically again makes you either heavy attack or intercept frequently. And we can definitely see kind of a common trend here in Act 6, what Kabam are trying to force us to do. Luckily, Wasp is a really great kind of foolproof answer to a lot of it, combined with Nick Fury synergy. So again, we can use these passive evades, passive shocks to get rid of all the Fury buffs if we wish to do so. So we can parry his opponent freely right about now. And now we pretty much just have to finish the fight off. Opponent's also under concussion. He has no ability accuracy. He has weakness debuff, which replaces with pretty much every single one of our heavy attacks, which reduces their attack by 30%. As we can see here, we're only 19 hits in. That big King Groot is already like halfway through his health pool. Now we pretty much just need to land in a special attack and the fight's gonna be over. I think I'm gonna do a small slip up here just because I'm not gonna watch my combo meter closely enough, and I'm gonna end up having 2 charges on me and I'm not gonna be able to remove all of them before killing King Groot. So we're gonna take a small damage back. But yeah, the fight itself was super easy and it's over already in 40 hits. King Groot with huge health pool down like no problem at all. Next, we're gonna move slightly back a bit to 615 with Power Struggle global node, and again this fully immune Iron Fist on aggression regeneration node. So take in mind that this Iron Fist is fully immune, however he's not immune to passive stun, therefore we can still play as normal. Basically that passive stun gets around pretty much everything, including Mordo. I should mention that I did use Wasp in 625 against Mordo boss, and I did manage to solo that boss with Wasp on multiple occasions. I am probably gonna clip that out from the stream and post a separate video soon, just to kind of showcase how well Wasp was dealing with that 625 Mordo, which is quite annoying. But anyways, back to this fight. So we have absolutely no problems kind of keeping pressure on opponent, chaining heavy attack after heavy attack, placing our passive stun. Aggression regen hardly ever comes into play, and if it does, we can simply out damage it, because pretty much every single hit we do is critical and every heavy attack deals like 10k plus damage, which is quite crazy for rank 1 6 star. But yeah, so the fight is over here already, again in like 30 something hits. So another great piece of utility Wasp has based on her heavy attack playstyle is simply the fact that she can bypass pretty much all of the auto block nodes, just because you can't auto block heavy attacks. So when we're playing against Medusa, our game plan is always to land in one hit and chain into our heavy attack, and then even if the auto block triggers, it will not do anything basically, just because heavy attack hits through blocks. So with that, they can't stun us, they can't punish us. We do not have to worry about living strands, as we can see here. It can't trigger against us, it can't do anything to us, and combined with our explosive damage output, we have absolutely no problems taking this Medusa down, pretty much ignoring her abilities once again. And now when we have concussion debuff on her with yellow jacket synergy, which to be fair we're not going to be using too often, it's kind of nice to have utility belt under your but still, that also helps you bypass stuff like auto block regardless. So Wasp can by herself without any synergies completely destroy any Medusa you find, just because her auto block will never be a factor. And next bit, I'm going to show that interaction once again in between Wasp and, let's say, Bane node. So this Hyperion is stun immune, he has Bane on. However, this is pretty much a perfect fight to showcase. First of all, with yellow jacket synergy, we can place a concussion to disable his power gain, so he's not going to be getting any power gain buffs while we have that concussion on. Second of all, there I took some Bane damage on purpose just to showcase that if we have Nick Fury synergy charges left on us, while opponent's gonna be trying to hit us, we're gonna actually be kind of transferring Bane back to them because that hounds that evade with the shock damage as a landed hit, which is awesome for nodes like Bane, like Brute Force, or whatever else you need to kind of like land an attack on opponent on a timer, and that makes it just so easy. And once again, we had the passive stun, so we could ignore the stun immunity as well. So let's go over some realistic, potential, awesome teams that you can use with Wasp. So obviously, Wasp is a BFF with Ghost, so that is going to be always in your questing team. Then you absolutely want your Nick Fury in with, instead of Ant-Man, with Quake synergy, just because Quake is an awesome champion as well. And Quake enables the evade synergy, so it's going to help out your Wasp, it's going to help out whatever else, whatever other champions you bring. So that is a really solid 4-man core. Now you obviously may choose to bring in Hood with you to finish off your Ghost kind of combo with Wasp and Hood, and then take no damage while phasing. Another potential really great option is Captain Marvel, just how well she works with Nick Fury, and her binary charges last longer, and then all your Fury buffs gain extra strength as well. Then you obviously can take in Goldpool. Goldpool works awesome just because he increases special attack damage, and he also is going to let you heal and have a lot more sustainability. But here we're going to talk potentially about most important thing. So it's a 3-man synergy, perfect for AW, perfect for, wait for it, that annoying Aegis node, because Wasp's evade counts as an intercept, which I showed in my video against Aspect of War nodes. So you can use this synergy to basically have a foolproof 3 intercept easy access to disable that indestructible from Aegis. Also, Wasp herself has absolutely no problems landing heavy attacks to kind of disable the second Aegis heavy. Therefore, you can completely kind of cheese through that node in the war with this team, and all that pretty much foolproof. In addition to that, Quake is an amazing Alliance War attacker that deals a lot of problem nodes, and I suspect her to be one of the MVPs for the next season because of the new map changes, because of how many Aspect of War, Unstoppable, and otherwise different annoying stuff we have to deal with there, and Quake deals with majority of it. Now, with help of Wasp and Nick Fury, that could potentially be one extremely solid Alliance War attack team. But yeah, anyways, that's gonna be me done for today. I do hope you guys did enjoy the video. If you did, feel free to hit that like button, hit that sub button, share it with your friends, share me what you think, whether you could potentially be willing to test out this team in war. Anyways, let me know how it goes, and I'm gonna see you guys soon.